It's the tax.
Governor Perry, in your state, you have a 6.25% sales tax. Would taxpayers pay more under the 999 plan? Yep.
Herman, I love you, brother, but let me tell you something. You don't have to have a big analysis to figure this thing out. Go to New Hampshire where they don't have a sales tax, and you're fixing to give them one. They're not interested in 999. What they're interested in is flatter and fair. At the end of the week, I'm going to be laying out a plan that clearly, I'll bump plans with you, brother, and we'll see who has the best idea about how you get this country working again. And one of the ways, right here in Nevada, you got 8+%. You want 9 cents on top of that, and 9 cents on a new home, or 9% on a new home, 9% on your Social Security, 9% more? I don't think so, Herman. It's not going to fly.
Mr. Kennedy, 30 seconds.
This is an example of mixing apples and oranges. The state tax is an apple. We are replacing the current tax code with oranges. So it's not correct to mix apples and oranges. Secondly, it is not a value-added tax. If you take most of the products, take a loaf of bread. It does have 5 taxes in it right now. What the 9% does is that we take out those 5 invisible taxes and replace it with 1 visible 9%. So you're absolutely wrong. It's not a value-added tax. Now, one other quick thing.
Your time's up. I'm sorry.
This whole thing about...
You'll have another 30 seconds. Trust me, they're going to go...
Tonight?
Yes, I guarantee it. In about a minute, Congressman Paul, you called his plan dangerous today.
It is, because it raises revenues, and the worst part about it is it's regressive. A lot of people aren't paying any taxes, and I like that. I don't think that we should even things up by raising taxes. So it is a regressive tax, so it's very, very dangerous in that thing, and it will raise more revenues. But the gentleman asked the question, he didn't even ask what we're talking about. He asked the question, what are you going to replace the income tax with? And I say, nothing. That's what we should replace it with. But I do want to make a point that spending is a tax. As soon as the government spends money, eventually it's a tax. Sometimes we put a direct tax on the people, sometimes we borrow the money, and sometimes we print the money. And then when prices go up, like today, the wholesale price index went up 7% rate. And if you look at the free market, the prices are going up 9% and 10%. So that is the tax. So spending is the tax. That is the reason I offered the program to cut $1 trillion out of the first year budget that I offer.
Mr. Kane, 30 seconds.
Once again, unfortunately, none of my distinguished colleagues who have attacked me up here tonight understand the plan. They are wrong about it being a value-added tax. We simply remove the hidden taxes that are in goods and services with our plan and replace it with a single rate, 9%. I invite every family to do your own calculations with that arithmetic.
Governor Romney, you have your own 59-point plan. In the last debate, Mr. Kane suggested it was too complicated. Is simpler better?
Oftentimes, simpler is better, but, and I know we're not supposed to ask each other questions, but if you permit, Herman, are you saying that the state sales tax will also go away?
No, that's an apple.
Okay.
We are replacing a bunch of oranges.
Okay. So then Governor Perry was right.
No, he wasn't. He was mixing apples and oranges.
Well, but will the people in Nevada not have to pay Nevada sales tax and in addition pay the 9% tax?
Governor... Romney, you're doing the same thing that they're doing. You're mixing apples and oranges. You're going to pay the state sales tax no matter what.
Right.
Whether you throw out the existing code and you put in our plan, you're still going to pay that. That's apples and oranges.
Fine.
Yes.
And I'm going to be getting a bushel basket that has apples and oranges in it because I'm going to pay both taxes.
No.
And the people in Nevada don't want to pay both taxes.
No.